Hey everyone, it's Alexander, the real Mr. Robinson. Welcome to the channel. This is my review for the fifth Disney animated film, Bambi, which came out in 1942. The movie is based off the book called Bambi, A Life in the Woods, which was published in 1923. And the movie pretty much follows the life of this young deer named Bambi, who is the prince of the forest. We start out with him as a baby deer and we watch him grow up throughout this entire movie. We get to see him make friends with other woodland creatures like Thumper, a rabbit, and Flower, a skunk. We see him experience all the troubles and dangers of living in the woods. We get to see him experience the death of his mother. Spoilers for the one person who has never seen Bambi for some reason. And that's pretty much it. It is essentially a slice of life movie from Disney, and it is really good, but it's not really one of my personal favorite Disney movies. And part of the reason is because it's just got too many cute moments for my taste. I'm just jumping right into the negatives right now, and honestly, that's the only negative that I have. Like I said last week, Dumbo is an absolutely adorable movie, and if you thought that was cute, then Bambi here is just cute overload. Probably cute overload to a fault, and that's just my own personal taste. Maybe it's because there are more cute moments in this movie than there were in Dumbo. Maybe it's because there are more cute animals than there were in Dumbo. But it's just too much for me personally. And honestly, since I don't have kids, this is a Disney movie that, while I own, I don't watch it that often. There are plenty of other Disney movies that I would watch over Bambi any day, but that doesn't mean this movie is bad, not at all. Because unlike Dumbo, the animation for this movie looks a lot more cinematic, similar to the first three movies Disney made. And the art direction is just gorgeous. The backgrounds of this movie are probably the most beautiful Disney has ever done, at least up to this point. And the person you have to thank for these beautiful backgrounds is Tyrus Wong, who is the film's art director. And the look for this movie is just absolutely iconic. With just the backgrounds alone, it has this soft look to it. The edges don't look very rough. And it just makes it really a work of art, as if Fantasia didn't already prove that animation could be art. But the characters are also a big step up from other Disney movies. The designs for all the deer look more realistic than what we saw in Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs, which definitely had more of a cartoonish look to them. But then again, Snow White was the first Disney animated movie, so you can give them a pass on that. And the characters are fun. Like I mentioned, they're all very cute when they're children. Bambi, Flower, and Thumper. And another thing I love about the movie is that it doesn't really explain a lot. There's a lot in this movie that doesn't really get touched upon. The movie doesn't hold your hand. It doesn't talk down to kids like you would think a movie like this would, because there's a lot of mystery surrounding certain elements. We never actually see man as he goes through the woods hunting all these adorable creatures, and of course being the bastard responsible for the death of Bambi's mom. The father is never really that much of a character at all. There's a lot of mystery to him already, to where Bambi's probably afraid of him. He gets less than 10 lines of dialogue. The first time we even hear him speak or take responsibility for Bambi is after Bambi's mom gets shot. And I'm actually gonna say this right now, and this is my own personal preference. The death of Bambi's mom is actually not the saddest moment in Disney animation for me. I know that might be sacrilegious to say because it is a heartbreaking scene, don't get me wrong, but I just feel like because this sequence has been parodied so many times, it's one of those things like, say, the origin to Spider-Man. Everybody knows the death of Bambi's mom in and out, that it's almost common knowledge. You could just be born today, and you already know that Bambi's mom dies in the movie. So it's not to say that this scene isn't powerful, because it absolutely is, but I just feel like there's some more sad moments throughout the Disney animation canon that hit me more. Honestly, Baby Mine, which I just talked about last week in Dumbo, hits me on a more emotional level than Bambi's mom does. The death of Mufasa in The Lion King, which we're months away from talking about, is more impactful to me than the death of Bambi's mom. But again, that's just my own personal preference. And I think another reason for that is because the movie moves so quickly, you don't get a whole lot of time to just really take in the fact that Bambi's mom is dead. As soon as Bambi walks away with his dad in the snowstorm, the scene fades to black, and then we cut back into a very cheerful song with two bluebirds just being romantic and all. So you really don't get a whole lot of time to process the fact that Bambi's mom is gone. But that being said, Bambi is an absolutely wonderful movie. The animation's great, the art direction of the backgrounds is just gorgeous. It is very short. Not as short as Dumbo, but it never feels like it stays too long. And in a way, it's a pretty bold movie for Disney to make. There's not really a conflict, there's no three-act structure, really. It's just the life of this deer, and it is essentially the closest that Disney would probably get to making a Richard Linklater movie, where his best movies are just a slice of life with no real conflict. This movie is essentially an animated Richard Linklater movie, which I would love to see Richard Linklater do an animated movie, but that's beside the point. As a grade, I would say it's worth seeing in your lifetime. This is one of those other Disney movies, much like with Fantasia, where you kind of have to be in the right mood to watch. You can't expect something flashy or really funny or out there. There aren't really a whole lot of songs in this movie to begin with. In fact, what songs are in this movie aren't the result of characters just breaking out in a song and dance. So another thing that's pretty unusual for Disney. It's still another great movie and another great lineup in Disney's catalog. And there you go, that's my review for Bambi. And this marks the end of the first era of Disney animation known as the Golden Age. Because much like with Pinocchio and Fantasia, Bambi didn't do that well at the box office and really didn't make a profit until much later in life. And of course, the reason is because European and Asian markets were cut off due to World War II. Except by 1942, the United States was actually involved in the war. And from this point on, up until the 1950s, Disney animation would consist of either World War II propaganda, outreach films, or packaged films, which the next era of Disney animation is sometimes known as, the packaged film era or the wartime era. And for next week, we're going to be looking at the first movie in that era, Saludos Amigos, which I gotta be honest, I don't think I've actually ever seen. I've seen snippets of it, but I don't think I've ever seen this movie from beginning to end, so this will be an interesting review coming next week. But now I want to know what you guys think about Bambi. Whatever your thoughts are, let me know in the comments below. And until next time, this is the real Mr. Robinson telling you there's only one. Hi everyone, I just wanted to say thank you all for watching my review for Bambi. Make sure you like the video, subscribe to the channel, and share me with your friends. Don't forget to follow me on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, go check out my Twitch channel, support me on Patreon, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Have a good day, take care of yourselves.